Hello my friends and welcome to this unboxing video. My new soldering iron has finally arrived. Once I've removed the packaging, inside is a smaller box and the labels will start to give away what I've got. It's come from Farnell, which is a UK electronics supplier. So opening the smaller box, we are presented with even more boxes. And at this stage, I can't hide anymore the brand that I've chosen to go with. So there are two boxes of that size, two long boxes. Soldering iron tip, and an unlabeled box, but the contents of this will become apparent later. We've also then got a few spare parts. Not sure exactly what they do, but from my understanding, they are parts of the actual soldering tip. There we've got the main box, which unfortunately appears to have already been opened, which is a bit of a pity, but nonetheless. This is the WX2, and on the inside also a few more surprises. The main unit wasn't wrapped in plastic, and when I bring it up to the light you can see that it's slightly dusty, so unfortunately it does look like I may have got a display model, but nonetheless, as long as it works, I'm happy. If we explore more in the box, we've got a UK power cord, some sort of accessory just lying loose, and a European style power cord, and of course the manuals, which are very important because the menu system for the WX2 is not the most intuitive to use. So anyway, let me get that packed back up. So starting with the soldering iron stands, I'm just finding my massive pocket knife. You can see it's got very basic packaging, but it's not a particularly fragile part, so I wouldn't expect amazing packaging here. That is the stand, one of the stands. Notice at the back the three rectangular openings, and this is the second stand, which has got three circular openings. Both the stands came with metal wool. And Now moving on to the irons themselves. This is the main soldering iron. And since the base unit is the WX2, which is 2-channel, I can take 2 irons. So this is the secondary, which are a pair of soldering tweezers. I was quite surprised at the size of the actual soldering iron. I'm used to irons which are a bit more chunkier, and this is definitely a lot smaller, more like a pencil compared to what I'm used to. So just taking off the cable ties, I really like these, that style, so I'm going to keep those. And plug that into channel 1, and there a quick twist on the front, and that locks in. So unlike many other models where there's a screw thread and you have to tighten it down, this connects very quickly and locks very easily. So now we get to that unknown box, which at this stage I realized must be the tweezer tips. So they come protected with a bit of sleeving, and then they're marked with a left and a right side, and they slide in with quite considerable force and click in on the inside. There's a round connector on the inside. It's not a thin connector, but it has a similar appearance to a thin round with multiple pins. And here I'm just checking for accuracy, making sure that those tweezer points come together nice and tightly. And we move on to the main iron, and you'll see that the soldering iron tips use a 3.5mm audio jack, which I think is exceptionally clever. It's a tried and tested jack, and the tips slide in with a nice positive click. This tip is a very, very fine chisel tip, and the rubber portion where my thumb is, that obviously doesn't heat up, so you can literally pull the tips out while the iron is on, rest them in the holder, and plug a new tip in on the fly, so they're hot swappable. Another one of my favorite cable ties, so keeping that as well. I decided at this stage that I'd rather have the tweezers on channel 2, so I'm just shifting them to channel 2 and plugging the main soldering iron into channel 1. And there again you can see that quick twist of the connector to lock it in. Okay, do a bit of a clear up. And the tweezers fit so nicely in their holder, really easy to get them in and out. Power cord came with an unusually difficult cable tie. Get rid of the plastic protector. Unfortunately, a rather short power cord, but I have plenty of those lying around, so I will replace that with one of a suitable length. Notice here how I try and pick it up with one hand and can't. So that's the difference in quality between Weller and your cheaper soldering irons that you can pick up in one hand. This definitely has some weights to it. So it's switched on now. There are more than enough videos on YouTube showing all the features and functions of the WX2. The display pretty much shows the current temperature of each iron, shows if it's in standby mode or if it's at heat, and it also shows predefined temperature settings so that you can switch between them just at the touch of a button. So all that remains is getting the metal wool out of its protective packaging, and then we're ready to go. I did find that the metal wool was a bit little. I need to bolster that up a bit. So now just to find a donor board. There we go, an old ADSL modem that is no longer required, and this is what we are going to play with. So coming in for my second attempt, the first component I took off did ping across the room because I was applying too much pressure, but I learned, well, two things. It doesn't require a lot of pressure, and I also just had to up the temperature slightly. I had it a bit low for easy removal of components. So that came off without much hassle. If we move on to a capacitor, slightly smaller component. So that one tombstoned, which is a bit tricky because one is tempted then to use the tweezers like proper tweezers and pick the components up, whereas it would probably be better to have a pair of ESD tweezers in the other hand just to actually grab the component if you do lose grip on it. That one came off nicely. And that's another reason to have a second pair of tweezers, is that the components do tend to stick to the soldering tweezers. So here I'm going for some flatter capacitors. I've got the temperature up now to, I believe, 375. Yeah, and also just getting used to the pressure, and you can see how quickly and easily these components are coming off. So this was a very, very flat component, but you can see got excellent grip. Those points of those tweezers really do come together nicely. And unlike, you know, cheaper soldering tweezers, the chances of slipping, well, I didn't slip once, and I'm not exactly a professional tweezer user. So these components are really flying off here. Tiny resistor. So this is really great if you have a suspect component, a suspect SMD component that you want to take off a board, test and put back, instead of whipping out a hot air rework station and having to wait that, you know, for that to heat up and possibly removing components that you don't want with the tweezers. You can get in very quickly and get just the components that you want out. You put both the soldering iron and the tweezers in the holder, they go into standby mode, then the temperature drops to 120 degrees Celsius. But the minute you pick them up again, they back at full temperature within seconds. And there, in a few moments, I had removed a whole load of components. I was actually having so much fun that I carried on taking more and more off, but I think you get the picture. It's super useful tool. I didn't film it, but I also tested the soldering iron itself, and that was also an absolute pleasure to use. That super fine chisel bit really is able to get into amazingly small places. It doesn't, however, fulfill all my needs, as it only removes components that have got two legs, so I will be needing to get a chisel tweezer bit for the tweezers, so that I can remove SOIC packages, you know, the surface mount ICs, anything that's slightly larger and got more than two pins, and yeah, then I should be set. You'll see the Weller tweezers in numerous videos coming up. I've got quite a few faulty devices that need SMD components replaced. So yeah, it's going to become one of the most used tools in my videos. If you like that, subscribe and give me a thumbs up. Thanks for joining me today. Cheers then. Bye.